The sinking of the Titanic is one of the most famous ship tragedies in history. After the news came to shore, newspapers were flooded with death and disturbing experiences in the moments of the tragedy. During the night of April 14, 1912, the bridge received 6 warnings for sea ice from the Outlook. But when the Outlook spotted the iceberg, the ship was traveling at her maximum speed and wasn't able to turn in time. The iceberg struck her starboard side during the turn and ripped the metal right from the hull. Water began to flood in the lower sections of the ship, including the fuel area where workers were still shoveling coal into the furnaces to keep the ship running. The RMS Titanic sank from the night of April 14th and completely sunk on the morning of April 15th. It took the RMS Titanic 2.5 hours to completely leave the surface and sink. Between 1,490 and 1,635 people died out of the 2,224 passengers it was carrying on board. Some people were reported to have died from hypothermia just trying to swim to the lifeboats. Everyone knows it was the Titanic that sank. But was it really the RMS Titanic? The Titanic had 2 other sister ships built before and after the Titanic's own construction in 1911. The RMS Olympic was the first ship built in the series of 3 ships, and the history of the Olympic has some very interesting things. There is something about the RMS Olympic and RMS Titanic that needs to be explained. The ships were both completely identical, inside and out, due to them being in the same series of ships. There are only a few differences between these 2 vessels. Some of the differences were the number of portholes on each side of the ship. The Olympic had 16 portholes, whereas the Titanic only had 14 portholes. Titanic construction photos also show interesting things: the spacing of the windows on the top decks. As you can see, there are major differences between these 2 photos, but history claims it is the same ship. The Olympic had some dangerous crashes in its history, and the most major collision the Olympic had was on the 20th of September, 1911. The Olympic collided with British cruiser, the RMS Hawk, and created major damages on the Olympic starboard side. A large legal argument ensued, and the verdict was that the blame was laid on the Olympic. The Titanic was then finished a year later in 1912. The ship was brand new and the insurance on it was very high, which means if the Titanic sank, the White Star Line company would receive an extremely large sum of money for the ship because it was so new. The conspiracy of this began even before the Titanic set out to sea. The conspiracy is that the company swapped the ships and replaced the Olympic with the Titanic. The Olympic was already damaged due to the RMS Hawk collision and more likely to sink. People believe that days before the Titanic set out, they changed small things on the Olympic to make the ship seem more like the Titanic. Both vessels were almost completely identical. Both ships had the famous grand staircase and all the features the Titanic had except for the strength of a new ship. They would switch the ships and have the Olympic sink under the Titanic's label and collect the insurance money. While the real Titanic sat in the harbor, the Olympic sank under the name Titanic and the company was granted a large sum of money for insurance. Now let's take a look at the evidence, starting with the portholes. There was a photo taken when the Titanic was about to be sent out on its maiden voyage. In the photo taken, there are 16 portholes on the side of the ship, the same number of portholes that the Olympic had. The Titanic was only made with 14 portholes, and that is some evidence that the ships might have been switched. Another piece of evidence is when James Cameron went down to see the leftovers of the Titanic and found the letters M&P on the side of the ship, the same letters in the name Olympic. He photographed these findings and brought them to the surface, and it further fueled the conspiracy. In this time period of the Titanic, there was a massive coal strike that had thousands of people looking for new jobs. According to the records, the Titanic was having an almost impossible time trying to find crew to work on the Titanic. But why? Rumors. They had heard talk of the swapping of the ships, and it left an uneasy feeling in workers. One would think that people who are desperately looking for jobs would jump at the opportunity of working on the world's biggest and most luxurious ship. Many celebrities bought tickets, including JP Morgan, who is the most powerful and rich person in the world at the time. But he did not show up for the voyage. Rumors state that he had heard that the ships had been swapped. JP Morgan stated that the reason he didn't go on the voyage was because he was very sick, but the New York Times spotted him the following day walking around with his girlfriend, completely healthy. He was one of the many celebrities that did not sail that day. The changing of the ships were known by civilians before the ship even sailed, and some workers on the ship knew what was going on. James Fenton was a worker on the Titanic that survived the tragedy, and when survivors got to shore, the government was there and said that if you say anything, we'll throw you in jail for the rest of your life. James Fenton kept quiet for all those years, and on his deathbed, he told everyone what really happened. On his deathbed, this was his quote. "The Titanic didn't sink that day. The Olympic did. All of the survivors have passed away, and no one on that day is alive, but the story has been carried on that the RMS Olympic sank that day. With this theory, there are also some flaws in it, such as, who was in on it? People don't know if Captain Smith was in on the plan since he died with the ship, but before the Titanic, he was the captain for the Olympic. Captain Edward Smith was the captain during the incident of the Olympic crashing into the British cruiser. Edward was already responsible for several crashes, and the Olympic sinking in place of the Titanic may have been his last mistake. There are even more theories that are not supported that the company had staged the sinking and had rescue boats following it to rescue survivors, but the Olympic had crashed into one of the rescue boats and caused a pre-sinking situation. We may never know if the Titanic really did sink that day. The secrets and the answers are laying on the bottom of the Atlantic."